Insomniacs have different brains, weird brains, super tired brains. God, I hate my insomnia. Anthony Carboni here for DNews, and I had the worst insomnia from junior high almost all the way up through college. It is awful. You're always drained. You can't think straight. You're depressed. And while insomnia can be a symptom of a lot of things, we've never really pinpointed what the physiological changes in the body that makes it happen specifically. Now, I never saw a specialist about it, but I'm pretty sure I had delayed sleep phase disorder. It's common in teenagers, and it basically means your circadian rhythm is all off balance. Your biological clock doesn't match up with the day and night cycle. It can get less severe as you get older. Mine only happens for a couple of weeks at a time now, and then it'll go away for a bit. Insomnia can also be caused by psychological things like stress or physical issues like sleep apnea, but researchers looking to start treating insomnia at the biological root of the problem have found a potential culprit: plasticity in the brain's motor cortex. Now, we've talked about neuroplasticity before. It's your brain's ability to adapt and change to different stimuli and situations. It means that if you want to change your habits or get better at something, you can, because your brain will adapt to it eventually. The going theory was that since people who suffer from insomnia have decreased memory and a hard time concentrating and retaining information, their brains would be less plastic. Maybe being unable to process all that daytime info leads to sleeping problems. But a new study out of Johns Hopkins University says no, an insomniac's motor cortex is way more adaptable than someone who can sleep easily. They hooked up some healthy sleepers and some insomniacs to electrodes, and they tried some transcranial magnetic stimulation, or TMS, on them. Basically, it delivers precise levels of electrical currents to parts of the brain, but not in a weird shock therapy seen it in the movies way, in a more controlled, FDA-approved, let's study the brain and try to help people sort of way. So basically, they train sleeping subjects using TMS to move their thumbs in a certain way in reaction to stimulation. I feel like the more I explain this, the less safe TMS is gonna sound. Anyway, then they tried to retrain the subjects to have their thumbs move in the other direction, and the insomniacs adapted to the change much more easily. So what does that mean? Is an overabundance of neuroplasticity bad? Is it causing insomnia? Or is it from the brain of an insomniac trying to help the body cope with all the other physical and emotional stresses that come with a lack of sleep? This is where I go, the researchers aren't sure, and you all groan and thumbs down and throw rotten vegetables at me. But here's what's good and exciting about the research. If the overly changeable motor cortex is connected to releasing all the stress hormones and causing all the other emotional issues of insomnia, TMS could be used to calm the brain down and help people get into the habit of healthy sleep. It'll also make diagnosing legitimate insomnia much easier, because right now there's no way to objectively test for it. So a lot of people think they're insomniacs when they have other more easily treatable issues, and vice versa. In the meantime, if you're up, you can always tweet at me. There's a good chance I'm up too. You can also thumbs up this video. You're just sitting there in the dark. Just thumb up the video.